Alrighty, well, morning everybody. Well, time for some Gem of War. I just come from playing some pinball here for a few hours. So I'm just gonna be on this long enough to do the dailies and try to do most, if not all, the raid boss event. So yeah, I got time, so there's no faction assault or any other big things I need to get taken care of, so I'll be able to devote most of the time to raid boss. Then, if I have time after that, I might cut into some PvP, but we'll see come later. And there's gonna be a lot of background noise. I bought a brand spanking new fan last night. So, and I got it on the lowest setting, and it's pretty loud. But yeah, I have to have it over, I have to have it blown over my hand. Help keep it, keep my hand cool and dry. Otherwise, not much else to say, so let's go ahead and get her. And then, I'm going to go ahead and swap out albums. I don't know what yet. Well, I guess we'll go with this one. If you guys have ever heard the band Minor Threat, a popular 80s punk band, or specifically an 80s straight edge punk band, yeah, this is a parody band. Let me back up. This is a parody of that band. It'll make you kill your parents.
I want to see this lunchroom get torn up! Circle back!
Oh, okay. Jose, I could definitely cheer the very first track here. I gotta turn this down. Holy shit. It's like I have to yell over it. Yeah. I definitely like the first track. Karakoff. Oh, okay. International Cat Day. Didn't know. That's an old Henry Rollins line. Keep your body lean, your blood clean, and your mind sharp. Yep. Huh? I failed miserably at the body lean part, but the blood clean, the mind sharp. I'll do the best I can.
Hey, well, you, my theory.
Period between my late teens, when I got when I moved out of my house and got a roommate, to probably my early to mid 20s, that was when I did my most hardcore drugging. But once I left my roommate, I started tapering off. I was still a pill popper. I think I popped like a bottle a day of mini pins. They're also called, I think they're called trucker tablets. They're uppers. I did that for some odd years. But at some point later, I can't remember. I can't give you an exact date, but yeah, I did quit them. Matches. But yeah, it's... I forgot what I was gonna say. But yeah, I'm a straight edge guy myself, but when you're around other people doing drugs and they're all having a good time, the peer pressure and all, it's kinda hard to not do them. I might have said this in other streams, but it's easy to be steadfast in your beliefs when they're not being challenged. Back in my teenage days, I used to be like that too. It's like, man, I'll never do drugs. I'll never touch that back. Or I'll never touch that stuff. Fuck those people, man. Let them destroy themselves. But then, when I get my own apartment, when you get a roommate that, or when I get a roommate that's all kinds of into drugs, it's kind of hard to avoid, them. So. And I kind of brainstormed it too a few days ago. It's probably one of the reasons why a lot of bands do drugs. Not, part of it's just because you're going to the same place, you're playing the same music at all these locations when you go on tour. You're playing the same thing over and over. I mean, that's gotta drive you up a freaking wall. I know that from, working retail jobs for like 35 years, being forced to listen to the same shitty music every day. So yeah, that's one of the reasons why a lot of those bands get into drugs, just something to help you. There's a word for it, I can't remember what it was. It helps dull the pain. And then secondly, too, I think their fans factor in, too. Like backstage parties and stuff. In fact, now that I think about it, I want to say Ministry. The band Ministry, I think they were the ones that said it. But when your audience, they have the weekend off and they want to go out and go to a concert and party and all that. If the musicians tell them, nah, no heroin for me, no thanks. They, they end up getting shit from the audience. You end up pissing off their fan base, so. So it's not always by choice why musicians do drugs. They're just in a position where they have to do them. I know, Jake the Snake Roberts has talked about it, when he was doing the Joe Rogan podcast. He quit getting high like 20 years ago when he first started doing drugs. I mean, the high ain't no longer there. I'm sure that's true for a lot of musicians, too. I mean, they basically stopped getting high when they started getting high. It's like they have to do them. They'll get backlash from their fans, and they won't buy their next album, and they won't get their 2 cents for every album they sell or whatever super low number it is. How long ago was that? I can't see that being in the 70s. It sounds like it's something recent. Okay. Well, like I said, way back in the day, like 70s, 80s, I couldn't really see that happening. Just, I think it was a lot more acceptable, a lot more common and acceptable to do them back then. That's what it was, yeah. You could also say nigger and spick and all that back then too. Nigger, spick, and gook. And even the minority people were using those words as well. And it was just, I think back then it's what you did. It doesn't necessarily mean racism. These days, if you use those words, everybody gets all up in arms about it. Matches. Hey, 40% kicked in. Take all day. That's enough. Listen. All the good that's gonna do me. Not a damn bit. not much. It up. No, no one did anything. That kind of sucks ass. For all the good that's gonna do me. Guess I can't do anything else. battles are long. Looks like I gotta get up and walk. That was my fault on that one. Grasping at straws. So it looks like we get to get off and walk. That ain't gonna work. And she is diseased, so basically the battle's gonna take twice as long. Yeah, 19 stinking hit points. Alright, next album. Fuck it. Just for something. Bit of a standstill. Fuck it. Just for something. Thank you. fucking day. Looks like we're just gonna go back and forth like this now. What a fucking long slog. Oh, looks like you're reflected. That's gonna do me. Not enough. Match. Lock it. I got no choice now. Nope. I have to start doubling up on the singles now. I have to be able to one-shot Trask. Battles are already taking forever on a day as it is, so. Get my surge. Fuck it. What to do? Something. Something. Lock it. Just for something. Won't be enough. Nope. Stone skin. So. Fucking day. Yeah, stone scan. I still got him sooner. Lug it. All the good that did me. Something. 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 This to be over. Didn't get my surge. Looks like they're getting all the matches.
Ass!
Something. Good, that's gonna do me. Oh, misread that. You got lucky. Holy shit. Man. Looks like a teacher came loaded for bear. Luckily I'm still in third, so. Or I got brought back up to third. I think I was in like fifth or sixth earlier. Thank you. I'll go ahead and, I'll do these vaults. I might give PvP a once over. Otherwise, I'm definitely gonna be shutting down pretty quick. Shitty board. That's a shitty board. Guess I got something out of that, which looks like I didn't. So, luckily pulled that shit at the start of the battle before I killed two of them. More stinky bullshit. Some more free matches. Went my five match. So let me give, let me look over at PvP real quick. Okay, welcome with that. Yeah, not much going on here apparently. I ain't fucking with y'all, that's where the attack of Shakas are. Mech. Probably not. I ain't in the mood to screw with it right now. Probably don't have any of the required troops. Off the fur. No, I don't, Tina. I've got all week for this, so no big rush. Very off chance that I get lucky. Nope. But otherwise, yeah, that's gonna do it for me, everybody. I'm gonna go ahead and call it good. Just need to get going on my post-production stuff. Gotta get all that done. The stream vids all exported to YouTube and all that good stuff. Probably gonna have to lay down too because I'm beginning to. So. Definitely gonna have to lay down here. So, yeah. But otherwise, good session. Some good pinball. Did really good. Good and solid. I probably very, very, very few times where the screwing up I was doing was really chronic or enough to like really bring me down. So, like I said, good solid performance overall. But yeah, glad FX3 worked. I'm glad it only crashed one single time. So, like I said, normally it does this in phases. I go through a long phase where FX3 works and then a long phase where it doesn't. But no, broke the streak. So, but otherwise, once again, thanks for dropping by, everybody. I appreciate that. And I am off tonight. They're cutting hours. So, this week and next week, I'm off on Wednesday, so I should be able to get another stream going again tonight. Like I always say, my default time is midnight, but what it's been going on lately, I'm usually around between 10 to 11, so. And the times are U.S. Central. But until then, thanks again for coming by, everybody, and I'll see you all next time. Take care.